Good morning. Today, by online learning, we discuss class 8 chapter from Honeydew book, Tsunami. So, first of all, see from where this word get originated. It's in Japanese word. Tsu here means harbor and nami here means wave. So, tsunami is a Japanese word. And its mean is a long high sea wave caused by an earthquake or other disturbance. This is called tsunami. It's caused by an earthquake or a sudden shake under the ocean or under the water body. This is called tsunami. So see how it's affect and how it's occur. Here are some images.
Oh, all over when tsunami occurs on 26th December 2012.
In Tamil Nadu, you can see how the wave occurs and all happened due to sudden shake under the earth or under the ocean. Because of that vibration, this type of waves occurs and cause tsunami. In Sri Lanka, and so it's a sudden alarm from natural, from nature. It's a sudden alarm from nature that stop harming earth. If we harm earth, from that also we get result or we get consequences. So let's see tsunami chapter. On December 2004, a tsunami hit Thailand and parts of India such as Andaman and Nicobar Island and Tamil Nadu coast. Here some stories of courage and survival. Kachol Island, Port Blair, and Tilly Smith from Thailand. It's a story about a girl, about animals who survived as it's believed that they have sixth sense. It's a story about animals also, that how they survive from this disaster. So Kachol Island, you can see in this Nicobar Island, here is Kachol. Andaman and Nicobar is divided by 10 degree line. and this Cachol Island is on Nicobar. Okay, so here are few stories about the peoples, how they survive. Okay, so let's see first story. Story of Igneous on Cachol Island, Andaman and Nicobar.
The tsunami. The story recounts a few incidents of bravery and quick thinking during the tsunami of 2004. Ignatius lived on Cachol Island in the Andamans with his family. On 26th December 2004, his wife felt the tremors and woke him. The family ran outside. In the confusion, three of his children ran in one direction with him. The other two children, his wife and father-in-law, ran in another direction and were swept away by the towering waves. Sanjeev was a policeman on Cachol Island. He saved his family and then jumped into the water to rescue the cook's wife, but they were both swept away. The giant waves also swept Meghna, her parents and more than 70 other people into the sea. She floated in the sea for 2 days, holding on to a wooden door. She was brought to the shore by a wave. When Meghna was rescued, she was walking on the seashore in days. Little Almas and her family were visiting Nankauri Island for Christmas when the tsunami struck. While they were running from the waves, her father and grandfather were swept away. Then, her mother and aunts were swept away too. Almas climbed onto a floating log of wood and fainted. She woke up in a hospital. Almas was so traumatized that she refuses to talk about the incident. British schoolgirl Tilly Smith and her family were on a vacation in Thailand. Tilly was standing with her mother on the beach when they saw the sea rising and foaming. Tilly remembered the video of a tsunami that her geography teacher had shown in the class 2 weeks before. She screamed and asked her family to run away from the beach. She was so insistent that many other tourists also left the beach with them. They ran to the third floor of the hotel and stayed safe. It is believed that animals possess a sixth sense or have more acute hearing that helps them hear or feel Earth's vibration when we cannot. Although 1.5 lakh people were killed when the tsunami struck coastal India and Sri Lanka, the animal casualties were far less. In Yala National Park in Sri Lanka, people observed elephants running away from the beach an hour before the tsunami hit. One Sri Lankan man attributes his safety to his dogs, which refused to go for their daily run on the beach that day.
So you can see here are the few stories about the survival and about the courageous people, how they survived from this disaster. So let's see now Cachol Island. So now hear the story about Cachol Island. Unfortunate Ignatius that I show in your video. The first story is about Ignatius. His wife woke up at 6 a.m. sensing an earthquake. Ignatius put the television on the ground to save it from the quake. Then all the members of the family rushed out. When the tremor stopped, they saw the sea rising. This caused them confusion. They ran in but in opposite direction. His wife was swept away. Her two children along with the father and brother were also lost. Thus, Ignatius lost his wife, two children, his father-in-law and his brother-in-law in the tsunami. Second story is about brave Sanjeev, a policeman. He managed to save himself, his wife and his baby daughter. Then he heard the crisis for help. They were from John's wife. John was a guest house cook. Sanjeev jumped into the water to save her. They both were swept away and drowned. Then fortunate Meghna that I also show in a video. Meghna was 13 years old. She was swept away along with her parents and 77 other people. She held onto a wooden door and kept floating on it for 2 days. She was brought to the shore by a wave and saved. Now Another story is from Port Blair. Tragedy of Elms. Elms was 10 years old. The family was sleeping, but the father had woke up. He saw the water receding after the tremors. He knew it would come back with great force. He woke everyone trying to rush to the safer place. As they ran, his father fell down. Elm's father rushed to help him. Then came a big wave and swept them both away. Her mother and aunts were washed away too. They were swept away with the tree they were holding on to. A log of wood. Elm saw a log of wood floating. She climbed on it. Then she fainted. She woke up in a hospital in the Kamota. Now it's a story from Tilly Smith, Thailand. Now hear the story from Tilly Smith from Thailand. As you saw before in video, here is the story again of Tilly Smith. Let's see.
This story is based on a true story about a girl called Tilly Smith. She's from Britain. She studies geography at school. In December 2004, Tilly was 10. She was in year 5 at school. Mr. Kearney was her geography teacher.
What is a tsunami?
It's a tidal wave. Earthquakes under the ocean cause tsunamis.
2 weeks later, Tilly and her family were on holiday in Thailand. They were on a beach.
Look! There are lots of bubbles in the ocean. The boats are moving a lot.
Look at the waves! They are very big!
Suddenly...
How strange!
What's happening?
Where's the ocean?
Tilly was very frightened.
Mum, Dad, Holly, quick, run, run! It's a tsunami!
What's a tsunami?
A tidal wave!
Run, everyone! Run!
Run to the hotel!
There were lots of people on the beach. Minutes later, the tsunami tidal wave was at the beach. All the people from the beach were safe.
We are safe here.
In September 2005, Tilly was in London at an award ceremony for bravery.
Well done, Tilly.
Thank you.
Back at school...
Well done, Tilly. You're so clever.
Yes, Tilly. I'm really proud of you.
So it's a Thailand story, Intelligent Tilly. This is a story from Thailand. Tilly's family had come to Thailand from England to celebrate Christmas. It was December 26. She was standing with her family on the beach. Tilly and her mother, Penny Smith, both saw the water swelling. The beach was getting smaller and smaller every moment. They saw the sea slowly rise and start to form. Tilly saw the sea making whirlpools. Now, bad sign. Tilly's mother was not alarmed by these signs. Tilly remembered the video that her geography teacher had shown in the class 2 weeks before. It occurred to her that these were the sure sign of tsunami. She screamed and asked her family to go off the beach. The mother did not sense anything terrible. She, however, felt that her daughter must be right. Tilly the savior. Tilly's parents took her and her sister to the swimming pool at the hotel. Many others also left the beach with them. Then it was as if the entire sea had come after them. The family took refuge in the third floor of the hotel. The building withstood the force of the tsunami. If they had stayed on the beach, I would have been dead. So, It's a story about brave girl Tilly, how she become the savior. Now, animal survival is the third story about how animals survive. The animal sense. Some people believe that animal possesses sixth sense. Tsunami killed 150,000 people, but only a few animals died. In Yala National Park in Sri Lanka, 60 visitors were washed away, but only two animals died. In the same park, people had observed three elephants run away from the beach an hour before the tsunami hit. A man on the coast near Gale in Sri Lanka has had two dogs. On that fatal day of tsunami, they refused to go to the beach with their master. So the master too stayed back. Thus the dog had saved his life also. So here stories of all the survivors or the brave person come to an end, and it's a really very beautiful stories about the courageous people and also the animals, that how they by sixth sense or they have that power to first inculcate that something going to be happen. They have that power and they save themselves. So it's a tsunami when it occurred on 26 December 2004. These all the stories from that disaster only. I hope you understand the chapter. Thank you and have a cheerful day.